Newcastle has a new unofficial and perhaps unwanted title today. It is, in the words of one national newspaper, the tree-felling capital of the UK. That's after it was revealed the council had chopped down 8,000 in the last 3 years, almost twice as many as any other local authority. Andrew Hartley is in Newcastle now. So, Andrew, firstly, where have these figures come from?
Well, they emerged from a Freedom of Information request from the Sunday Times. It found more than 110,000 trees have been cut down by councils across the UK in the last 3 years. Almost 8,500 were in Newcastle, many more than in any other local authority. The next highest was Wiltshire, with just under 5,000.
So why has Newcastle been chopping so many down?
Well, I guess they call it progress, Carol. Sometimes trees have to make way for homes and roads. In South Gosforth, for instance, 500 trees and shrubs were removed to allow road improvements on Killingworth Road. And there will be many more trees felled. The City Council has approved plans in Walsington, close to where I'm standing, for 1,000 trees to be axed to make way for a hotel and housing complex.
So really high levels in Newcastle.
Yes, they are, but the City Council wouldn't be put up for interview today. They point out that there are, guess what, around 800,000 trees in the city. So 8,000 lost, well, you do the maths, that's about 1%. And they issued a statement and they say where trees have been felled, this has been for a good reason. They're dead, diseased or dangerous, or they're in the way of some kind of development.
So I'm sure environmental campaigners aren't happy.
Well, no, there have been a number of fights in recent years to save trees in the city. In Gosforth, remember this, 2 years ago, at the Blue House roundabout, residents fought and succeeded to save 100 trees. And here, close to the Great Park, where I'm standing now, environmentalists are fighting plans for 1,200 new houses here, close to the Great Park.
Newcastle is already well below the national average for tree cover, and the council have admitted that themselves a number of years ago. But I mean, as you can see from where we are here, I mean, the devastation that's caused, it's not just trees, it's hedgerows as well, all the type of green infrastructure that we have in urban environments. I mean, this is on the fringe of the city, but it's a really important habitat for wildlife. And unfortunately, the council just don't seem to be prioritising the natural environment as much as they should be.
And Carol, just one final thought. The council will point out that for every tree felled, planning conditions usually stipulate that two must be replanted.
Thank you, Andrew.
Back to you.